Okay, so if you've been through all the other videos, you'll have learned lots and lots about what we can adjust, why we adjust it, different crops and whatnot. There are very few manual adjustments on the machine where you have to get the spanners out, but I want to talk to you about setting the gap and really what's happening underneath these motors with the springs and the adjusters. So in terms of the clod roller adjustment, we've mentioned about lifting them up and down through the electric ram and the whole lot moving up and down together. What we've got left to adjust is the gap. Now, if you can see under the machine, there'll be a little clip that we can show you better. We do have each clod roller sprung loaded. And when I say sprung loaded, the idea of the sprung loading is if it takes a large object between the two rollers when it's trying to extract it. We obviously would prefer the spiral rollers to deform around it, but when it gets to a bigger size still, we want to protect the mechanism. And the way we protect that is spring load the clod roller. So it's free in actual fact to move away from the spiral roller if it absolutely has to. And the way that works is each clod roller, this is the end of the clod roller shaft, is on a hanger. In actual fact, it can swing away on a pivot just behind the motor here. What holds that in place is that spring pulling it back, and to put it in the correct place, we have a adjuster bolt. It's a domed headed or a cut square bolt, 12 millimeter with a nut each side of it. And what we do at the factory there is we hang all the springs on loose, and then we use the adjuster bolt to pre-tension each spring. Now, this is not how we adjust the gap, this is just the pre-tension of the clod roller spring. That's all we do use this bolt for. So, these days, everything is CAD designed and laser cut, and we know the welding and all the components and the stops and the positions of everything are identical on both sides of the machine. So when we set the first tension on the first spring, and when we're setting tension, we're talking about pulling those coils of the springs apart slightly to see some daylight. So we don't want that spring pulled open like a bloody great bull worker. We just want to see a little gap. So you can see on our springs here, a little tiny gap between each coil, and that's set by adjusting the domed headed adjuster bolt. So, as I said, when we build them in the factory, we set the first bolt, get that one right, and then we measure the distance between the head of the bolt and the lock nut. And we do exactly the same on all bolts for all spring adjusters on both sides of the machine. So, six clog rollers, six springs on each side, so 12 altogether. Every one of them is set exactly the same. So there's a bit of advice when you're stripping your machine to replace parts. Don't worry about too much when you're taking it apart, but when you put it together, always set your spring tension and make sure every one is set exactly the same. What that does, it avoids you having a situation where the clog roll is slightly pushed further forward on one side to the opposite side, and you've got variations between clod rollers. When we adjust the gap, we actually adjust the gap of all clod rollers at one go. It really is a very simple process to do. So we presume that all the springs and the tensioners are all set exactly the same on both sides. So now we're looking to change the gap between the spiral roller and the clod roller. So if I just point to you one here, look, so this is the end of the spiral roller. That's a fixed shaft polyurethane roller. It's not going to move, and then the clog roller is the one behind it. And what I'm looking to do is move it further away or closer to. Now, the way we do that is by moving what we call the left-right adjuster panel. And connected to that adjuster panel is the adjuster bolt and the spring. So whenever we move that plate forward or backwards, spring tension doesn't change, it stays the same. very easy to do. There's a couple of ways of doing it. Trust the spanner. My preference is a long socket on a breaker bar, because it's just easy to get hold. And what we've got here, we have a couple of pinch bolts that stop this from sliding forwards and backwards. So what we do is we just slacken these two pinch bolts off. I'll just show you how we do that. It's as simple as put the socket on. Probably a quarter of a turn just to loosen it. The second one's at the back here. So that's just released the tension on it. You've probably just seen the roll is just, that plate just slide a little bit on its own. So setting the gap, really quite easy, really quite easy. So what we have is a rack and pinion star. It's a little star wheel that runs through a row of small teeth. This is why I use the breaker bar. It's quite difficult to put my spanner on there and adjust it because there's quite a lot to be moving. So the better way is a nice long bar, a long socket that slides on the end of that adjuster there, and then I can quite easily just move that backwards or forwards. And as you can see, it's moving all of them back, all of them forward. Once I've got it in the position I want it, main crop potatoes, where we're running the clod rollers in reverse, we want the smallest gap, perhaps just the thickness of a piece of paper. The way to set it is to visually get on top of the machine and have a look at that gap. So what we normally do is just put it just where you want it, have a look, make a fine adjustment. If I'm happy with it, sometimes it's better just to hold it, two hands, pop your spanner on, just pinch it off. And then what we'd normally do is just have a better look. Just make sure that gap is exactly where you want it to be. So we'll do that, just make sure everything's where we want it. Because all my springs and my bolts are set in the same position, the gap will be the same on every one. So then it's just a simple case of just pinch those bolts off and we're done. Well, we're done on this side, but in actual fact, we have to do the other side as well. But it's the same process, just in the mirror image of what we've got just here. So just to summarise that really, double check they're all the same, make sure the nuts are tight, check your gap, lock it off, make sure these pinch bolts are nice and tight because there is quite a lot of load on this machine that's pulling big rocks through. But it's really just as simple as that.